At the height of World War II, millions of men were sent overseas to fight for freedom. But back home, that left a gap. Who would build the tanks, airplanes, and other equipment needed to support the troops? The answer? Women. Millions answered the call, leaving home and heading to the factory. One of these women? Connie Palacioz. Connie worked at the Boeing B-29 plant in Wichita, Kansas.
In 1943, I went to Boeing to work, and I riveted the nose section of this plane from here down to the end.
And Connie loves to tell the story about the work she did and the women she worked with.
The first day that I was at Boeing, I did not rivet because they said I didn't have a buckler. The next day, my lead man said, "We have a buckler, but nobody wants to work with her because she's black." And so I said, "Oh, I don't mind working." So they brought Jerry Warden, was her name. And I tell you, she was the best buckler. If she hadn't been that good, I couldn't have done that my job either. Yeah. And we became a pair. And we built 1,644 planes.
To further share her story, Connie volunteers at the B-29 Dock Hangar Education and Visitor Center in Wichita, Kansas.
I just greet them, and then I'll take them to the inside of the where the plane is. And then when they want me, they want to take pictures with me and all that. So
Dock is one of only two flying B-29 Superfortresses. The airplane flew again for the first time in 2016 after a massive restoration project, and Connie brags just a little about how well B-29s like Doc were riveted.
It was in the desert 42 years, and there were only seven rivets missing. So we replaced those, but the others are still the original ones that I riveted when I was 18. I'm 95 now.
But mostly Connie is just grateful to serve and tell the story of women like her who made such an impact serving in World War II.
I'm blessed with good health that I can still do it again.
Josh Cochran, AOPA Live.